Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lamola, if you don't know, and I post commentary videos like this one together with hair and lifestyle. So if you're up for that kind of trio, better subscribe. I actually forgot to make an intro and I realized when I was editing, that's why it's, I look like this and I couldn't dress up and just enjoy. So before we start the video, I want to explain like one or two things. Okay, many people reached out to me, okay, not many, but then a few people reached out to me and they were like, what has happened? Have I forgotten my YouTube password and stuff? I was busy. See, now life has been good and bad. Like, anyways, it's been 2 weeks, but then I'm happy I'm back and grinding and ready to post back consistently. As I'm posting today, expect another video on Sunday and so on and so forth. Thank you for always supporting me. So let's get into the video. Today we are going to be talking about sexualization. So if you don't know what sexualization means, it's like a polite, like a subtle way of saying sexual objectification. So sexual objectification is when you regard somebody as an object to fulfill your sexual desire, which is usually what happens mostly to women than to men, because I've never really seen where men are sexualized. Like, they are, I'm not sure that they're not, but the women are more subject to these things than men, and then they suffer the most. So the reason why I wanted to talk about this today, like, because it's not the initial video I had planned to talk about, is because it's been happening, and it's been happening very, I don't know. And then now there was this incident with this gospel artist, this teenage gospel artist that just happened, and then I felt like I just had to talk about it. So let me like give an example, like to give meaning to what I'm saying. Like women wearing revealing clothes, or maybe sitting some kind of way, or saying some kind of things, or texting some kind of things. People who over sexualize women tend to interpret what they wear or what they say the wrong way. Like, I don't know. Imagine, I had this conversation with somebody because she put on her story that how can somebody go to church and then lead prayers and worship with a crop top. Then I felt like, let me mind my business, because that's not my business. But then I felt like, why is she posting this on her? I asked her, what's the problem? Why are you posting this here? Why are you not going to go and tell the person personally if you have a problem with what the person wears? Which you shouldn't have a problem with somebody wears, because that's none of your business, first off. Then now she was like, she's a pastor's daughter, and then now that was very indecent for her to come and lead praise and worship, and part of her stomach was showing out. And I was like, okay, did you tell her, like, did you go and meet her after the service and be like, this? She was like, no, I did it. I was like, why are you coming to tell us? Is it our concern? Like, seriously, it gets very annoying. And then now I was like, so what was indecent about it? She was like, she's turning on the male people in the church. Like, on a serious note, if you're a boy and you're turned on by a girl's stomach, like you're turned on by inches of a girl's stomach, are you okay? Is something not wrong with you? Because I don't understand. Like, and then she kept on reposting it, because other people from the congregation were posting, and she was screenshotting and reposting. And I was like, you guys talk to her if you have a problem with her. Don't come on here and start, I don't know, drying her dirty laundry in public. Who does that? That's my problem with Christians. That's like my main problem with Christians. Y'all claim, I am a Christian, Kingo, I am a Christian. Y'all claim that there are certain things that people don't have to do and stuff and stuff. Meanwhile, the very Bible that we all read says you have no right to judge anybody, because you're not any better. You have no right to judge anybody, especially for exposing the person like that. You're even doing more harm than wrong. If according to your the church you go to, you are not supposed to dress that way, then why don't you go and meet the person? Why? And then now the problem is that she said that men are going to, that she's promoting lust. And how are you turned on by stomach? How? You see, people have made it in such a way that if a woman reveals just a little part of her body, you're, I don't know, sexualize it, glorify it, and make it as if it's something. The second incident that prompted me to shoot this video was, Indira, the gospel artist that I said just released a music video. She released the music video and she was well dressed in the music video. She was wearing, you know, you don't wear one dress throughout the video. She wore a series of dresses, gowns and stuff. Then now there was a part where she wore jeans and a hoodie. So the hoodie was a cropped hoodie, but then nothing was showing. The only problem that people had was that she wasn't wearing a bra. First of all, is that your business? Second of all, people were like, that's indecent, she's supposed to be wearing a bra and stuff like that and stuff like that. Who said people are supposed to? It's a choice, eh? It's a choice if you want to, because I don't even wear a bra every day. I genuinely hate wearing a bra, and I can say that is true for 90% of the girls in the world, because first of all, uncomfortable. In fact, nah, let's just leave that problem. The problem is that under her comment section, the day that she posted the video, people were bashing her for not wearing a bra. That girl is 18. And so people were like, she's luring men and stuff, she's a gospel artist, she's not supposed to. But what is the problem? They weren't even showing. They were fully covered. The only problem was that she was not wearing a bra and her nipples were, I don't know, pronounced. And that meant that she was turning on men. Okay, if you are turned on by something that you can't see, then you should start doubting your psyche. Like, you should start doubting the way you think. Because I feel as if sexualization is the middle between, family, friendship and stuff, and sexual abuse. Because before you want to abuse somebody sexually, you must have sexualized the person in your head. You must have thought that this person would be a good something to satisfy your sexual desire. Like, are you thinking the way I'm thinking? So if somebody already starts looking at you in some kind of way, or notices the simplest things about you, like you not wearing a bra, you should start running. Because that's how it starts. That's definitely how it starts. And then now, I like the way she responded, because she was like, it's her body, which is true. People always tend to tell women what to wear, how to dress, how to sit, how to eat, how to talk. People tend to tell people how to do everything. Meanwhile, it's their life. If I choose to wear, see that, if I choose to walk naked on the road, I will. The only problem is that I am Christian and it's against my religion, and first of all, I will not be comfortable. But if somebody chooses, like, it's not your business. People have various reasons for doing things, and you have no right to judge anybody because you are not better. You aren't. Because it's this mentality that you think that somebody's sins are bigger than yours, that is why you have the right. There's nothing like that. There is nothing like that. I have promised myself that I will not talk about religion or politics on my channel, because these are very controversial topics. But then I'm seeing that those are things that rule the world, and in one way or the other, it must come up as a subject of conversation. So what I'm just saying is that y'all should stop, I don't know, taking everything deep. If I choose not to wear a bra like I am doing now, that's none of your business, because bras are uncomfortable. I've had bras that have wounded me. I've had bras that I've removed in class because I couldn't even concentrate because they were so tight, or they were so. Look, mind your business. Seriously. I just want to mention the consequence that all of this has on these girls who are growing. They say girls who are less than 15. The way they see these things, that means that they are forced to feel like they have to look a certain way, or they have to cover up in a certain way so that they are not going to be harassed, so that they are not going to be up the subjects of that kind of, I don't know, critique. They feel like really it's wrong. Like, I'm just creating this video to raise some sort of awareness that y'all should chill. People should chill with the way you look at women. And I'm saying this particularly to men. Like, if you're watching this video and you're a girl, feel free to share this video. And if you're scared, wait, if you're scared to share this video to your male friends, then start rethinking the male friends that you have. Because some people are predators out here. Some people are not rapists just because they still have a little bit of fear of God. Because by that time that fear of God goes, it's over. That's what I'm just saying, that just try to minimize the way you look at women. Women are not an object for your sexual gratification. Nobody gave birth to her child or is her child for you to come and for you to lust over the breast. First of all, lust is a sin. I think in almost all religions, lust is a sin. So it's really wrong. So guys, thank you so much for watching till the end. I appreciate all the feedback that I always get from you guys. If you have anything particular to say, comment down below. Share this video to your family and friends. They're not going to kill you. See you on Sunday. Bye.